Hi, it's Stacye. How are you today? It is Tuesday, not Monday, so I can't call this a Monday morsel. Maybe a Tuesday morsel, I don't know. Anyway, I apologize for the delay. I needed a moment, sorry. I was a little tired from my event on Sunday, and then yesterday I was just kind of in my feelings, a little overwhelmed. And I know that a lot of us are having those days. I admit when I have them, I didn't used to, but I will say this. I also didn't know what I wanted to talk about. And then I like to kind of suss out the world and see where we are. And what I noticed was there's this anger, and I know it's coming from the uncertainty. And I've talked about this before. None of us know what's happening. None of us. We're all, you know, out here on this ledge. But we're in it together. And I do believe if we work together, if we learn to be kinder to each other, to listen, we can survive this and get past this. It is very hard when, you know, most things we get up, we don't always know what's going to happen in our day, but this is severe uncertainty because now it's not just our livelihood in the moment. It's we don't know. We have no idea when this ends, when we go back to work, when, and not normal, but when we get to our new normal. And I see it in my day-to-day. I notice people are really starting to get frazzled. Even people that I normally find calm are, you know, they're going through it. Everybody's going through it. And I want to say this. Hear me, because I believe this in my heart. I know we're going to be okay. I know that being okay may require work and effort, but I know at the end of the day, we'll get there, because I have something I live by, so I'm gonna use that phrase. God don't bring you nowhere. You know, he's not gonna bring you to it if he's not gonna get you through it. And so I believe we're here for a reason. And let me share with you my reasoning. So I believe that 4 years ago, I try very hard to stay out of the politics, but I'm gonna use this because I think it's important and the politics kind of matter in this subject. 4 years ago, I believe that we were all very complacent. The United States ran on what we thought was autopilot, and everybody's life was pretty good. The economy was good, unemployment was down, you know, people were living, everybody was living the high life, everybody was doing good. And then a wrench got thrown in. And we started little by little watching some of our liberties and rights being shifted and taken away or whatever. And then all of a sudden, here comes coronavirus. And had it been true that it would have really went away in April, which is what everybody kind of hoped for and was planning on, I think it would be very different. But now we don't see the light at the end of the tunnel. We don't. Nobody knows when can we begin the new normal, because we're not going back to what was, but we do have to figure out and acclimate ourselves to what's new. And in the meantime, though, you gotta believe you're gonna be okay. You know, I can remember election night in 2016 or 2015, whatever the hell the election was, 2016. And my phone, texts, phone calls, all night. When I say all night, I mean all night. I didn't get any sleep. People were like, what are we gonna do? I'm freaking out. Okay. And I said to each and every person, we're better than this as Americans. And I wasn't worried. I have held that this whole time. But I also know, as I started watching things that were happening, we were complacent. We just thought everything continued to function. And a lot of people were complacent in their lives the same way, just functioning on autopilot. The thing about your life, your relationships, everything we do requires our attention, our tweaking, and our work, our effort. And a lot of us had just gotten too comfortable. We were completely uninvolved. Unlike the 60s, this is very much like the 60s, these marches that are happening. And now everybody's galvanized and we're paying attention. We didn't really have to pay attention before. There was no need to. Things just kind of worked out. You voted, things went on, but things changed. And so I look at where we are as a blessing. I know it sounds crazy, but I do. Because what I realize is it has made everyone wake up, be mindful and conscious and involved, not just in the politics, but in their lives. I've heard so many stories from people saying, I'm so glad I get to spend time with my child. I didn't realize my child needed XYZ. The teacher said this, but that's not what's going on. Or there's these things in relationships and couples have, you know, worked their marriages out because they got to know each other. And some couples got divorced because they realized, I know you and I don't like you. But the point is that this time period has made us participate in our life and in the world. And we communicate with each other and we talk to each other and we look out for each other. And that's what we lost. We became so detached that we lost our connection. And the coronavirus has made us reconnect. You go into any home store and the shelves are now empty, partially because they're having trouble getting their supplies, but because people are working on their homes. Something that they might have neglected because, well, they just didn't have time. Life was moving. I'm doing whatever. But now, oh, I'm home. Oh, my God, that tree's dead. Let me dig that tree up. Or, like in my case, I realize I've had more company in the last 6 months than I've had in the whole time I've lived in this house, but partially because there's no restaurants. And I love to entertain, but I hadn't been doing it. I would just meet my friends at restaurants. And so now I get to do what I love. I get to cook for people. And even while I was juicing, I've had company. I fix some lunch or dinner and we sit in the backyard. So I got my backyard together because it was my new living room and dining room. And so again, it's made us reconnect. We're connecting with our space, with the people in our lives. We are connecting. We are reconnecting to our world. And I think that that is the most amazing gift that we have gotten from this. We get to see just how important our real relationships are to us. To know that someone could catch this and go in a hospital and you don't even get to see them, to nurture them, to try to help them get better, to even say goodbye. I think that reality has really hit home for people. But find the blessing in this moment. Find the things that have gone good in your world. It's easy to let all of this stress you out. It's easy to let it overwhelm you. It's easy to let it just bring you down. But at the end of the day, there is a blessing in every challenge, and you've got to seek that out and hold on to it. And every day, find the blessing. Find the thing that motivates you, that makes you connected, that you care about. Because if I didn't learn anything else in all of this, I already knew what was important to me, but this just solidified that for me, to know what matters, who matters. Protecting my spirit is the most important thing. As some of you may notice, I don't really post political stuff on my page. I support finding or rather arresting and convicting the killers of Breonna Taylor. And yes, I do talk about Black Lives Matter because I'm Black and I know that I matter, but I need the people that didn't know to know. But I don't get into the politics. As I said, I'm politically minded. I watch it on TV all day. I know what's going on. But I don't discuss it because I find that to be this trigger for the bickering and all of that. And I'm not doing that because I'm trying to keep my spirit as whole and calm as I possibly can in this very challenging and uncertain time. And so what I recommend to you is to find the things that make you feel good. Hold on to those things. Hold on so tightly and appreciate them. And acknowledge, embrace, and have gratitude for where we are in the lessons that you've learned in this moment. I'm sure I've said it before, but right now, gratitude's more important than ever. So find your gratitude. My doorbell's ringing. Find your gratitude. I will see you soon. Have an amazing rest of the week. Love and blessings. Bye.